Hello and welcome back, my beautiful people. It's once more time to upgrade our Instagram bot. This time, we will have a look at comments. We will post some comments and we won't hard code it in our code. We will go to some posts, steal their comments, and comment them under other posts. Cool as that. Let's dig right into it. So, we need something to do before we can put in our method. We need to use a regex expression. A regex expression is something like you have a specific pattern in between, something like you have only alphanumerical values or only numbers in there. And we need it to filter our Chrome browser, can't put in some smileys or something like this. Therefore, we import re. And then it's simple as that. I will simply copy it because regex expressions are always, copy them and everything is fine. Compile. And there we put in the regex expression. I copy it and I'll explain it to you. This regex expression means we are looking for only alphanumerical values. So if a string has like hello and put in a point in there, the point will get filtered out and it's only the hello left in. Like, I have a little example in here. We have a regex expression. Here we have a star in between and the three, and let's have a look what's coming out. The star and the three are also filtered out because we simply want to get the alphanumerical values. If you're interested in more regex expression, I can do a video about it, but regex expression, simply copy them from Stack Overflow. You don't need to understand. Simply, these are for alphanumeric values, numbers, and no one understands them, just use them as they are already there. And now we are ready to go to our new function. This function means comment underscore post. Therefore, we need a self, of course. We want a number of comments, how many posts we want to comment to. We want a hashtag for the origin where we want to get our comment from. And a post hashtag. And before I forget it, like every time, I will call the function comment post. We put in a free. Get it from lifestyle because you can always get it from lifestyle and put it to programming humor because it's the best hashtag out there. Check it out. So, like this. Get one spacing out. And now, as always, we make a time.sleep at the beginning because we come from another function. And if it's like bad connection, sometimes it's cool to be a Python script because you can sleep all the time. We need a new array where we can store our comments in there. It's equal to this. And now we want to get the website where we have our hashtag origin to get the first post, to get the first comment off there. So our self.browser.get, put in the f string as always. And because we have the cool logic over here, like hashtag, can simply copy this function because half of the function can be reused for this case. So simply copy the code from above and we will simply scrape through it and copy this and put it in here. So we get a new hashtag. We can get rid of this. And now, as we are in a hashtag again and looking for pictures, this is exactly the same selector as above. So we can simply let this be there. And we only need to get rid of this. Because the next window is always the same. If you have multiple comments you want to scrape through and get out of it, we can simply scroll again like this. And now we have this to a hashtag underscore origin as our first value. Then we get the first picture, click on it. And we click on the first photo. And now This needs to be number of comments, of course. And let's have a look what's happening if we open the first photo. Oh, beautiful photo. We simply click on right click inspect and we are looking for the comments. And yeah, let's have a look at this. In here, each class is the MR508. And in here you have div, li, more div. There's the div. Ooh, even more div. Ooh, and there is the comment. So we have a div with the class C4VRMK. This we want to copy, and in there is the span. So the perfect way to get the XPath. And therefore we make comments is equal to self.wait for objects. We have, of course, with the, as always, multiple comments in here. By CSS selector. Not like this. I set the XPath, man. Yeah, like this. And now we need like this to get, not from the beginning, but go in there. We had a div, and this div had a class of, and as you can declare it in the XPath, you make like this bracket and put in there contains and what it should be containing. The contains is a function, so we put in this bracket and close this. And now what it's containing, it's a class, add class, and then you can put in strings the number, the value of the class, like this. And in here, in the class, there was the span. Like, now we get this class, and in here there's the span, and in the span, the text is the value you want to access. So, then we put in this and the span, simple as that. And we can simply print the comments at number 0.text. Yeah, we can then put in the exit 0, because then our script stops and the part beyond this one won't get executed. So let's have a look what's happening. And let's run the code. And now we got the Jinjin of code promo. Yeah, like this. We got her comment. So we simply go, we want to get the top comment, the best comment, because if you post the best comment again under another post, you go viral. It's insane. Yeah, look at me. I'm already viral. Yo. So we need comments. There's one.text. And now this is the case. You see, there's a heart and there's an add, and we want to get rid of this. So how are we gonna do this? Make a new variable called comment. And this is re. And this is our regex variable from above. Regex.sub. And in here we put in some apostrophes, and over there we put in the string we want to get replaced with our regex from above. So everything which isn't an alphanumerical value, we want to get rid of. And that's what is happening here. Can simply print our comment now, and then we put in the exit 0 again, and let it run once more. And here now we are into the picture. Let's have a look. Close it. Let Instagram open for the next time. And yeah, we see surely there's only alphanumerical values in there. And then we can get rid of this. Put in time.sleep as always. And we want to append this comment to our random comments to have multiple comments, as many as you want to get through. There we put in our comment. Then we have later list of comments. We get rid of this number of likes and put in a number of comments, of course. And in here, that's exactly the same. This is the last one, like we had the like hashtag. We scroll on and on. I modified it a bit because if you are in the last iteration, like you have a 3 in there, then you go 0, scroll to 1, scroll to 2, and you would even scroll to 3. but we don't want to have a look at 3, so I put in this. So we stop once earlier, so we don't scroll once more. Here. Now, we have all the comments. We need to post them. And this was a bit harder as I expected. But, guys, I solved it. It's a time for have liked this video, because this was a tough one. So, as above, we can get the self-load browser and go to another hashtag. Because we don't want to post them under the same post. So, this is not the hashtag origin. We go to the post hashtag, to the second value you can put into your the third value. We already have the number of comments. Like the third value you can put in your method is the way where we want to go with our new posts and put them. And surprisingly, it's also a new, like a new hashtag. So we need to click on the first one. And if we have a look, here we can post something. So we need to inspect it again. And that's one pretty simple to get, but it's pretty hard to write in. Not gonna lie. Like, what's this? Yeah, it's a text area with the class of YPFFH. So this is gonna copy now. And after that, if we write in here, we need to click on this button. But yeah, firstly, let's get it to write in there. As always, if you open it, make a time.sleep. Maybe you have a better PC than mine, so you can make less time.sleep. But I want to be on the safe side to not get crashed. Not crashing my bot anytime. And now we also take for I in range 0 to your number of comments. And the last thing, also copy from above, because we simply need to scroll on and on, like exactly the same amount of times of comments we get in there. And now there's two things we need to do. We need to write in the text area and then we post. So we need comment underscore box is equal to self.rate for object. I didn't show you that it's a unique one, but trust me, I've looked this up many times. It's unique and I didn't copy it. I'm an idiot. But now, yeah, we need simply this class. And now I can show you that it's unique. Yeah. What is going on with you, Dominique? Screen copy. Yeah. Ooh, I can copy a class from the internet. I'm an engineer. Yeah. And now, that's the strange thing. We need firstly to click on it. And then we need to get the same comment box again with the same value as above. Don't ask me why this is like this, but I tried it like 20 different ways and we need to do it like this. And then we can do the same thing as we had with the login. Like, as we now, you see, we have something written in there. If we click in, then it's focused and then we can write in there. So we need first to click in. But we need to get the object again. I don't know why, but then we can send our keys. Now we can comment box.sendKeys. Same as we had in the login, but it was much simpler. And then we can simply take our random comments at the value of I. So we have now, imagine you put in a number of 3. You take above, you scrape 3 comments from other posts, take them out. And now we loop through 3 posts and put in the comments we got. Cool. Pretty cool. Sleep of 2. And then we need simply to get the post button. How we get the post button? Power through it. Get this into it. And oh, 14. That's not cool. But there's a value in there. And we did it once with the following. We do it once more. We need an XPath where we can get the text value. So post underscore button is equal to save what wait for object by the XPath, of course. I'm talking it, but I can't do it. Yeah. And then we need button. And this button should have a text of posten. Make sure, I guess your Instagram isn't in German, so make sure you change the text in here to don't have an error later. Then make sure to close the brackets like this. And we simply can click this button. So it should post something. Then we make a time.sleep. And as always, in the end, we make a random time.sleep from 2 to 10. Not 100. I don't have that much time. I'm already 22 years old. I will die if I wait that long. And now, yeah, like this. And we this one gets the window once more. So we get to the next post, to the next post. But if we are at the last post of your number, we don't go any further. And yeah, I have this random time.sleep over here. Don't worry. It's always time for random sleep. So no one knows how long we sleep. And as I'm always having some errors, make sure send keys. Yeah, that's the method we need to use there. So now it's time to test it. And now we scrape through our comments. Oh, there's even a smiley in here. That's a cool thing. We can check it if it's working. And what? Yeah, you get rid of the smiley. Pretty cool. And it's posted. Like here. Yeah. Now, your Instagram bot can post under some hashtags with even random generated comments. Comment under some post like this. Yeah. With random generated comments, make sure to comment every single post out there. Use this bot. Hopefully you like the video. Subscribe to the channel. And as in the last videos, comment beyond my video what do you want to see next. I'm pretty thankful that you already comment so much. Thank you for this. And maybe there's another idea if you want to see, not like random generated comments, but we can also make web scraping, go to a website where the most common comments are posted and get them. If you want to see this, let me know. Thank you for your attention.